Good evening, everyone. How are you doing tonight? My husband and I like to cook, and we want to try cooking new things. I've been seeing cooking videos pop up on TikTok, and I want to replicate the recipe, but there's just one problem. This is what you get from the TikTok API. Look at this. It's unreadable. There's no line breaks. And the worst part, the app shows the line breaks just fine. I'm not sure what's going on there, but might be a limited YouTube DL, might be they're using the wrong line break characters, might be the wrong phase of the moon, who knows. But around the time that I implemented, I had a bad idea, new research released this model called Hermes 3, and they introduced something that I found really interesting, JSON schema-based prompting. So in JSON schema-based prompting, you put a JSON schema document into some XML tags and hope for the best, I guess. Usually the model that will output JSON that kind of, sort of, maybe matches that schema. Foreshadowing is a literary technique in which, so I put the descriptions and subtitles in the context window, and it worked. Sometimes. Sometimes the model would hallucinate how JSON works. Sometimes the model would put things in the wrong places. Sometimes the model would put the instructions in JSON keys instead of values, because why would things make sense? One other time, it told us how to make chlorine gas. This was not productive. So that's why I pulled out a JavaScript library I've not gotten the chance to use often, Zod. Hold on. This Zod. It lets you declare schemas and assert that objects meet them. Adding this to the pipeline did help, but there were some other problems. In order to make this more durable, let's say durable, I had it, if it didn't match the JSON schema, it would try again. It would try again. It would try again. And I still ran into issues. It would still generate invalid JSON and try again over and over for upwards of 20 minutes. This was not a productive use of my time. So the real solution here would be to use something like BNF grammar to weight ungrammatical tokens to negative infinity. Yes, negative infinity does exist, and if you're bad, you will go there. And the other problem is that the runtimes and the API I was using just wasn't set to use BNF grammar-based token weighting in the way that I wanted. Because why would we be able to have nice things in Anno Domini 2024? So I fell back on something that I remember seeing AI companies use in order to cheat benchmarks. It's a technique called multi-shot prompting. Most of the time when you tell a language model to do something, you don't give an example of the input and the output you want. You do it in zero shots. One-shot prompting is where you give it an example of input and the expected output, so you can give it input again and get the expected output that maybe is closer. Sometimes with like some of the bigger tests, like Gaokao, they have to do up to 5 different shots or give 5 examples of getting the right answer to a test question, and then it's able to extrapolate. Isn't our industry great? So this ended up working. I didn't collect metrics on how much it happened because it turned the average time from, like, I don't know, 20 minutes to 30 seconds, which is like maybe a factor of 10 increase. I don't remember how math works. I'm not a computer scientist. I just play one on YouTube. So now that I had this working with a bunch of super hacky JavaScript, I decided to use next.js to make it a little more robust, I guess. So I made a basic web UI, and when you click on the web UI, it fetches the video information from the TikTok API, throws it into Hermes 3 with Olama, and gets you stuff that you can print out and cook. So I could just give you a screenshot. I could embed a video here and fake it. Let's test God. So did I put it up here? So we have this video by Cooking in the Midwest. It's for making kielbasa sheet pan dinner. That is the actual name of the recipe. So I take the URL, I copy it, and I paste it into this incredibly professionally made UI. And did I wire it up to work on Enter? I don't know. JavaScript is not my strong suit. Let's do it with the video, with the browser inspector, so I can see it using up all my cell data. Okay, so it made a post, good. It got the stuff, good. And now we have to wait for Olama to think. and it's running a 70 billion parameter model on my MacBook directly. And pro tip, in order to do this, you need a lot of RAM, and don't buy a MacBook with 64 gigs of RAM, because every time you have trouble, they need to manufacture a new MacBook motherboard for you and ship it in from China. Ask me how I found this out. What is taking it so long? Is Olama thinking?
So you mean you can cook the recipe on your MacBook?
I mean, if you have enough the question that was asked is, can you cook the recipe on the MacBook as it's going? And it depends on what you mean by cook. Like, I mean, I'd assume that the definition of cook would include raising it to the safe temperature as defined by Health Canada. And, you know, infinite monkeys, infinite typewriters, Shakespeare. But I don't think that the battery in this would allow for that. And I think, like, all of us in this room are expelling more heat than this battery, like, in a minute than this battery has entirely. Oh, here, it worked. Wow, I was actually hoping it would. So, yeah, it gives you the ingredients, it gives you the steps, and this is what you have to do in order to cook things off of TikTok, because nobody gives you the freaking recipe, because recipes aren't copyrightable. And, oh, that worked, cool. So, when I first got this working, we wanted to test it at home. Due to some prior mishaps, my husband did not exactly trust the idea of using a Langle-Mangle to go in and generate the recipe. So I had to employ a little bit of this tool called deception in order to ensure this got used. However, unlike the last time where we ended up with inedible goo, this actually worked. We got an edible result, it was tasty, and now it's in our repertoire de cuisine, or whatever the hell that is in French. So, in the future, I want to improve it by getting a vision model into the mix, because sometimes TikTok creators will put the amounts of the ingredients on text, on screen, to stymie people like me. Because, again, recipes are not copyrightable in the United States, Canada, or most of the Western world that is subscribed to the burn copyright, whatever. I still haven't figured out what I need to do in order to extract the video frames. I assume that it would involve like several cans of Monster, a trip to the FFmpeg documentation, banging my head into the keyboard, and praying. The praying is the important part. Make sure to do all your FFmpeg hacking on a full moon. Don't ask me why. There's some other things I want to make it do, like use JSON schema-based BNF prompting so that I not only get it to emit something that's valid JSON, but it's valid JSON that matches the schema. There's some dark magic in the llama.cpp grammar that allows you to do that. But realistically, this is probably good enough for now. Asterisk. And with that, I've been Z. I'll be around if you have questions or want stickers, and stay frosty. I put the source code for this on GitHub. That's with the QR code that's not labeled. It's not a Rickroll, I promise.
Amazing. Thank you, T.
Any questions?
Questions for...
Does it work with any video? Probably. You know what? Let's tempt God. Okay. So there's this guy named Richard. I haven't actually limited this to like TikTok URLs. So will this work? Oh, one error. Requested format is not available. Apparently it doesn't work with YouTube videos. But it should work with any TikTok video, I guess? I don't know. I haven't tested this that strictly.
And languages?
It probably works best with English, French, or other European languages. I'd imagine that you would get, like, maybe something in something like Chinese or Korean or Japanese, but I haven't tested it. I would be afraid to test it personally, but... You know, you can raw dog life how you want to. The question was, do you rely on the voice to text from TikTok or what? And I rely on two things. I rely on the TikTok description, which in TikTok, the video description is both the title and the description, because why not? And TikTok uses, I believe, OpenAI Whisper Large V3 in order to generate subtitles on their end. So every video has high quality asterisk subtitles. And usually that's good enough. It's been good enough that I haven't had to figure out how to like hook it into like Whisper running on a GPU in my home lab. Although I do have Whisper set up on a GPU in my home lab, I just haven't wired this into this setup yet because I still value some of my sanity. If it was text-based, why 70B? Well, originally I did this with Hermes 3 405B via OpenRouter, but then OpenRouter took down the free Hermes 3 405B endpoint, and I found that out as I was preparing for this. Archie can vouch that when I was giving the demo, they had taken down the OpenRouter endpoint and the demo didn't work. So it's using Olama, it's using Hermes 3 70B on Olama as a last-ditch effort because I do have Hermes 3 8B running in my home lab. It's just, what's the polite way to say this? Bad? Yeah, it does work. Asterisk. Do I have control over the JSON format key values? That's what I was referring to with like BNF to assert the output matches the schema that I want. Right now, I am able to assert that it does match JSON. Like the example, this bunch of random text is actually the llama.cpp BNF JSON grammar, at least part of it that would look nice on a slide. So it does like make something that is JSON. But it doesn't make like JSON that matches a schema. That's why you have to have the second layer of ZOD in the mix to assert that it does match a schema. I cherry-picked a video example that I knew worked. There are some videos that it does work on, and there are many videos that it does not, but I have insufficient knowledge to know which videos fall in which categories. I am frankly amazed that this works as well as it does, because this was like a weekend hack of mad implementation, and it's a miracle of science. You mentioned using BNF to structure the output. Have you tried using framework buzzwords like Outline to do it? I don't trust any frameworks that I can't understand, because this stuff barely works as it is, and as you stack things that are potentially even more chaotic into the mix, things work even less. So to minimize variables, I am doing direct calls against Olama. And if I wasn't using Olama as like Docker for large language models, I would be doing direct calls against llama.cpp to be able to cut out all of the boktog involved and just literally get to the source as much as possible, because I cannot trust any of this tooling to work as it is.